हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सिक्स्थ इंग्लिश मीडियम। इन बायोलॉजी वी आर बिजी विद द चैप्टर नंबर 8, बॉडी मूवमेंट्स। नाउ इन दैट चैप्टर वी ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द मूवमेंट्स इन ह्यूमन बीइंग, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बोन्स, मसल्स, द रिब केज, etc. So now we have to learn about some other animals, because not everybody have the same situation as human being have, because some animals they do not even have the bones, but still they are moving. So how they moving? So here we are going to learn about the gait of animals. What is actually gait? Gait means the manner of forward motion. So different animals have different gait, means different types of situation to move forward. So here in this session we are going to learn about earthworm, then snail, then cockroaches and birds. Then how they move? What do they have in their body that supports them for the motion? So first of all, let us talk about earthworms. Everybody know what are the earthworms. Generally, in the rainy season, you will see lots of earthworms in the soil. In the farm also, you can find out soil when you dig the soil. So these earthworms, they don't have any bones, but their body is made up of rings, and all the rings are connected end to end in them. You can see the picture also. Here you can see that all the rings are there, and they are joined end to end to each other. And these rings helps them for the motion. So the earthworms has special types of muscles also. And muscles will help them to extend and shorten the body. So what do they do during movement? That first, it extends the front part of the body. What they will do, first they will extend the front part of the body. And what will they do next? Keeping the rear portion fixed to the ground. So the rear portion, back portion, will stuck to the ground, only it will move that front part of the body forward. And then afterwards, then it fixes the front part and release the rear end. So what do we do? First it will move only the front part. The back part it will keep like that. Then it move that one. Then it will fix that front part, and then it will take that rear part, and then it will move like that. Similarly, again it will move like that, the front part it will pick up, and then it will make forward. That time the back part will be fixed to the ground, and then again it will take up that back part, and so on. So by this way they will move on the ground. So this makes it move forward by a small distance. And repeating the small movement, it can move forward. So thus move forward by a small distance, repeating the expansion and contraction, expansion and contraction. And its body also secreting a slimy substance. That slimy substance help in the movement. So that is the situation Now the question arises how they fix their body part on the ground while moving. So they have on the under the body a large number of tiny bristles. Bristles means like small hair like structures that is projecting out, and with the help of that, the bristles are also connected with the muscles, and then with the help of that bristles and the muscles, they will have a good grip on the ground, and so by this way they move on the ground also. Now maybe you don't know or maybe know about it that earthworm, how do they eat? They eat through the soil. It means they eat the soil also, and from the soil they will get the nutrients, and after that undigested part along with that soil they will take it out of the body again, and which helps the soil to get more fertile, and therefore we say that they are the friend of farmers because they help to increase the fertility of the soil. So by this way earthworms movement we already saw about it. Now the next creature is the snail. Snail also mostly you will see in the this season of rainy season. They are very small things, and it had a hard covering on the body which is generally will be the rounded structure. I hope everybody has seen it, but I'm going to show you in the picture also. Yes, that is the snail jene apne gujarati ma gokad gai pan kahiye. Gokad gai pan ene gujarati ma tamara mummy papa ne puchi jojo. So that snail has that rounded structure on the body, and that is the shell. It is known as shell, and it is the outer skeleton of the snail. It does not have any bones inside, so no skeleton inside the body, and this outer skeleton is also not made up of bones but some other chemicals. So the snail, the shell has a single unit and does not help in moving from place to place. It has to be dragged along. It means that that shell is only to protect the body. It does not help any type in the movement. So when the snail moves, it has to take along that snail with it, that shell with it. So now how do they move on the ground? So what do they do? So place the snail on a glass plate. If you put the snail on the glass plate, then you will watch it properly that how it moving. When it starts moving, carefully lift the glass plate and you can see from the downward. So you will see properly how they can move. A thick structure and the head of the snail may come out of that opening. That from the cell. In the cell there is some opening. So from the opening a very thick part along with its mouth may come out of the shell. And then what happens with that? The head of the snail come out of the opening. The thick structure is called foot. The thick structure along with the head which is coming out is known as the foot of the snail. And that with the head, with the help of that foot, they will move the muscle. So that foot are made up of the very strong muscles, and with that muscles they can run, they can walk slowly in the on the ground or at a place. The wavy motion of the foot can be seen. If you carefully see that, then wavy muscle will move and then they can move forward. So now snail is very slow or fast compared to the earthworm, we can see that it can walk very slowly compared to the earthworm. Earthworm is little faster than the our snails. Now the next creature we are going to learn about is the cockroach. And you know, everybody know about the cockroach. And I know that most of the girls are scared of the cockroach. Just you saw the cockroach, they will start screaming. So these cockroaches, they can walk also, they can climb on the wall also, and they can fly also. You have seen them flying also. So now, how do they move? Actually, they have three pairs of legs. How many? Three pairs of legs which help in walking. So three times two means six. Three on one side, three on other side. So there are six legs, three pairs, and which help in the walking on the ground or somewhere. Its body is also covered with a hard outer skeleton, which is made up of number of plates joined together. So for the body, they have the outer skeleton also, and that outer skeleton is made up of different types of plates which are joined together and then permit the movement. So those plates permit it to for the movement of the body. Then what else they have? They have two pairs of wings which are attached behind the head. Behind the head, the two pairs of wings are also there. And then they have distinct muscles also near the legs. Then near the leg, they have distinct. Distinct means separate, different types from the other muscles. So that are the special muscles near the legs that allow them, they help them to move on the, they can walk through that muscles also. So thus, cockroaches have the capacity to walk also, capacity to climb also, and they have wings. So with the wings, they can fly in the air also. So that is the special arrangement in the cockroaches, so that they can do the motion of themselves. Then lastly, we are going to learn about the birds. Everybody know the birds. Birds can fly in the sky as well as they can walk or perch also on the ground to get the food. So now, what is the special thing in their body that they can fly? So their body is well designed so that they can easily fly up in the sky. So they can and some of the birds like duck, they can swim. Not all the birds, but some of the birds like duck, they have special type of arrangement by the legs so that they can swim in the water also. Now what is the special in their body? Their bones are hollow from the middle, means it is not like a very thick, but inside there is nothing, hollow space they say. Therefore they are very light, and because of the light weight, they can easily fly in the sky. So their bones are hollow and light. The bones of hind limbs are typical for walking and preaching. So the hind limbs means the back limbs, forelimbs mean the front limbs. These are our forelimbs, these are our hind limbs. So the hind limbs are very nice, they're typical for walking and perching. And the forelimbs are modified as wings. The forelimbs mean the front limbs are modified as wings. And that wings have the muscles. The shoulder bones are also very, very strong. And the breast bone are modified so that they can help in the motion when the they are flying to move their wings up and down. You can see how the skeleton of a bird is in our picture here. So they have very light body. Why they have light body? Because as I told you, their bones are very very hollow. And one of the things that is not in the book, but I can tell you, that they have some bags of air inside that are known as air sacs. That air sacs are there. I think there are 9 air sacs in their body. In that body, in that sacs, they feel the air so that their body becomes more light and it can be easily fly in the sky. So that are the very special features in the different type of creatures on the world, on the ground or at the water, whatever it is. They have different type of special structures that will help them in the motion, etc. So now in this chapter, in this session, we learn about the gait of animals. As I told you, what is gait? Gait means the manner of motion, forward motion. Actually, the forward motion is known as the gait. So in this section, we learn about the earthworm, then the snail, then the cockroaches, and lastly, we learn about the birds. And it is not finished yet. In the next session, we will learn about some other creatures like fish in the water, then the snakes also. So that will be in the next session. So today we are going to finish our session. Whatever is there, read carefully, watch the video carefully, write down the whatever there is PDF in the file, PDF file. There will be some maybe questions also there. You will write down, and if any type of confusion, please write down in the comment section. Thank you very much.